call that?
So the sampling instrument that I'm standing in front of here is the gravity core, and that's basically just a steel pipe with a lot of lead on it. It's about 1 ton in weight in total. And the end of the pipe is fitted with a core catcher, and that makes sure that we can keep the sediments in there. So this device can actually take 6 meters long gravity cores with minimal disturbance in the surface. It's a very powerful device. It's low tech, it always works. All it takes is an A-frame and a winch to deploy. We have 3 meters according to the seismic, but it looks like it also. It's our most important sampling device, so it's really invaluable for our campaign. We rely on this instrument to get long Holocene records that perhaps go back to the deglaciation of this region here in the Baffin Bay. So a core of 6 meters long is typically 10, 12,000 years old if we're lucky. Let's have a look. It's sandy. It's very sandy. So the entire gravity core is being cut into 1 meter sections, which will fit on pallets for transport, but also will fit the core scanner. So we pull it carefully out meter by meter, and then we cut it in sections. I think this core is like 3 meters or something, so we have to be careful not to pull out too much at once. We make sure that we label all the sections while they're still in the core in position, so that we don't mess up the direction. Yes, so these cores are going to be analyzed for a lot of different so-called proxies that we use to reconstruct past ocean conditions and climate variability in the last 10,000 years or so, depending on how old the core is in the bottom. Combined with the shorter sampling devices like the Rumor and the Hubs, we get a complete record from present day all the way back to when this region was covered in ice.